I want to talk about empathy. I want to talk about how my favorite film, Everything Everywhere All at Once, uses empathy to make you care about kindness in a strange, scary, and overwhelming world. And I'm going to argue that the way they do it is by making it personal. Directed by Daniel Kwan and Daniel Scheiner, Everything Everywhere All at Once is a crazy, over-the-top, sci-fi, kung-fu, comedy, action-drama adventure about Chinese immigrant Evelyn Wang, who is simultaneously faced with a tax audit, throwing a party to impress her estranged father, a possible divorce from her husband Wayman, and struggling to connect with her daughter Joy, as well as being the last hope of the multiverse and hunted by the multiversal being Jobu Tapaki, who is trying to end everything. It's a turducken of a movie, full of sausage fingers, talking raccoons and googly eyes that in its final moments culminates in an almost spiritual experience of watching two rocks in a desert and a hug in a parking lot. It's the kind of film that makes you go, how the f*** did they come up with that? Well, according to Professor Harold Shub,
story is a means whereby people come to terms with their lives.
And according to the directors, this was definitely the case.
We were trying to create a film that tapped into that feeling that we were all experiencing.
The too muchness of being alive right now.
Because we always knew it was going to be about nihilism, about how difficult it is to find meaning in a world that is just constantly barraging us with narratives that feel contradictory.
And can we make it feel like that and still give you some hope at the end?
Right off the bat, the concept itself is personal to the filmmakers. It deals with their own experience of being alive right now, and by doing so, they're tapping into a shared experience with the audience. Like John Truby writes in his book The Autonomy of Story, stories are
human life condensed and heightened so that the audience can gain a better understanding of how life itself works.
But the film is still batshit crazy. So how is it they managed to bring us from this to this without losing the audience along the way? In one word,
empathy.
According to screenwriting guru Robert McKee,
the audience's emotional involvement is held by the glue of empathy. If the writer fails to fuse a bond between filmgoer and protagonist, we sit outside feeling nothing.
And Everything Everywhere All at Once creates this bond of empathy with the audience by making it an intimate, personal story.
Because at its core, it's a family drama about a mother trying to reconnect with her family in the middle of all this noise.
It's a family of people trying to figure out how to get along and how to accept each other. And if that isn't the common link to every human being in the world, that's the beauty of the movie.
Throughout the film, we get to know how the main characters think and feel. For instance, we learn that Evelyn hides her daughter's sexual orientation from her father out of fear of putting more strain on her fraught relationship with him. And this way, even though we don't agree with her, we start to understand her and build empathy for her. As David Howard wrote in his book, How to Build a Great Screenplay,
more than any other factor, what keeps us emotionally invested in a story is understanding. We don't have to like or admire the character, but we must understand him and what prompts him to make his decisions.
And it is by keeping the focus on this family unit and making us care about them that we are carried through the noise of the multiverse and out the other side. And the way to keep this focus through an insane narrative that flips and twists and changes constantly is by making the antagonist, the multiversal creature that wants to destroy everything, an alternate version of Evelyn's daughter, Joy.
Jobu Tupaki is sort of this embodiment of the nihilist creature with inside the daughter character, Joy.
And the moment when we realized it was actually the daughter who was going to be going through that angst and that feeling that I think is so relatable, things just started to come alive and it just turned the, you know, potentially really messy film into a beautiful messy film.
And this decision doesn't just make it more personal for the characters, it also made the story they are telling even more personal to the filmmakers.
We kind of came around to the generation gap. It came around to like someone our age trying to connect with someone our parents' age. And the more we put ourselves into it, the more specific and interesting the family got.
To me, this is what most Hollywood movies do wrong today. They forget to make it personal. Let me give you another example. I like Mission Impossible, but I love Mission Impossible Fallout. Why is it that this film is the highest rated film of the franchise on both Rotten Tomatoes and IMDb? Because six films in, they finally managed to make the stakes personal. Most current large-scale films have a plot that hinges on saving the world. But there is an inherent problem in this kind of plot. It is far too conceptual for us humans to take in. Any large number of humans essentially become faceless. So instead of focusing on the millions that would die if the mission fails, Fallout spends most of the film showing us how much Ethan Hunt cares about the people around him. In fact, the entire mission is the fallout of refusing to sacrifice a friend. And so, at the end, when he climbs aboard a helicopter mid-air and rams it into another to try to stop a nuclear explosion, it is not the millions of people we worry about. It is his friends and loved ones still on the ground that we keep cutting back to. That is why his fight matters to us. We are emotionally invested in the climactic fight because he, and by extension we, care on a personal level. Everything Everywhere All at Once follows the same pattern and makes us care about the characters, not the multiverse. It uses empathy to make us care about the outcome. In their book, The Science of Screenwriting, The Neuroscience Behind Storytelling Strategies, Paul Joseph Gallino and Connie Shears argues that empathy has a basis in the evolution of our species. Human babies are dependent on adults for survival, and so...
early on, our emotional centers began to link endorphin release to these close, caring relationships. Thus, we feel good about family.
And as we developed a larger frontal cortex, where this link between endorphin and family takes place,
humans developed the capacity to extend emotional connection to others in the support system, paving the way for the capacity to connect emotionally to fictional characters presented in novels, poems, and cinema.
Professor Murray Smith, in his theory, Structure of Sympathy, identifies three specific stages of emotional engagement with fictional characters: recognition, alignment, and allegiance. The most important of which, I'd argue, is allegiance, where we are
responding emotionally to the traits and emotions of the character in the context of the narrative situation.
This kind of emotional response to the emotions of the character is what we see used so well in both Mission Impossible Fallout and Everything Everywhere All at Once, because the emotional response is relatable to our own human experience of family and other loved ones. But Everything Everywhere All at Once goes beyond this and uses allegiance in a way I've never seen done before. We not only see Evelyn and Joy struggling with nihilism, we experience it with them. The film is exhausting. It bombards you with action, comedy, high-concept sci-fi, and sillier ideas and images. The film itself is structured to make you feel overwhelmed, the same way the characters do. And in this way, it manages to not just be a film about something, the film itself becomes an experience of nihilism. And through this experience, we have empathy both with Evelyn trying to stay afloat in it, and eventually with Joby Topaki, as we, the audience, arrive at a point where everything feels like it's too much and has no meaning, and align with her.
Narratively, I think what we were trying to achieve there was a moment in which the characters, and hopefully the audience, fully embrace nihilism.
Nothing matters.
Which brings us back to kindness, and the film's main thesis that we have to be kind to one another. This is said straight out by one of the main characters before the final fight.
The only thing I do know is that we have to be kind. Please, be kind. Especially when we don't know what's going on.
Because his character, that's the heart of the movie. Our film is about kindness, and that's the most trite, like, you know, naive thing to make a movie about, but we wanted to give audiences a new way into that.
Within the context of the film, it comes across sincere. The film lowers your guard by making you laugh, overloads your system to the point of exhaustion, brings you to the point of nothing matters, and then tells you what does matter: caring and being kind. And it drives this point home with the strangest and probably most rewarding action scene in film history, where the mother, Evelyn, uses kindness to defeat her adversaries.
You know, most action movies, the subtext is that violence is the answer to problems.
We ended up creating a full-on action movie where the finale is an empathy fight. It's a fight about understanding and using your powers to be kind, which sounds so cheesy, but when you watch it, it's actually very fun.
But more importantly, the climax of the film isn't actually this fight, but rather this, the moment that always makes me cry. In the end, Evelyn letting go of her fear of failure, of judgment by her estranged father, and recognizing her daughter's need to be accepted for who she is and who she loves, is the real fight she has won. To truly see and understand those closest to you, and to be there for each other. At the end of the film, I honestly feel like I've been on a spiritual journey. And it does this by making you care about the characters while you're distracted by kung fu, sci-fi, and silliness. They do it by telling a story rooted in their own personal experience of being alive right now, bring the characters alive by drawing upon themselves and their own family members, and by keeping the focus of the film on the personal relationships between the three main characters throughout, and by using the medium of film itself to make you feel the same as the characters do. By making it personal, they create empathy and they make us care.
This is modern art.
It is masterful filmmaking and a true inspiration.